It's about YouTube. It's your boy BrocohleetV with another video. I gotta explain quick because if you can't tell, my cousin Francis hooked me up with a job interview. I think I'm testing pillars over at the Rooms to Go. They said the job title is a fluffer. I'm sorry. The manager was a little too friendly when I got here, if you ask me. Anyways, today we're gonna dress up some models. Whether you got a full 3D rig or just trying to cover up that big old head of yours, I got you covered like gravy on rice. I'll show y'all a few ways to slap some gree-gree on them suckers. And if you're streaming, don't worry, Shy. I'm gonna show you how to tie it all up with Streamer.bot real slick-like. Let me go ahead and run through a couple fits I cooked up earlier, quick fast. Now you can make them look a lot better than that. I just threw those together just to get everything working, you know. Didn't want to put in all that elbow grease and end up with a dead project. So don't worry, Kuyon. I'll show you how to get them 3D head wraps too. If this video helps you out, hit your boy with a like. Maybe subscribe if you're feeling jumpy like a catfish on a hot skillet. Got questions? Throw them in the comments or catch me live on Twitch at twitch.tv/broccoliTV. I'll give you the backwoods tech support, no charge. Oh, man, ma, hold up. I think I hear the manager stomping back. I'ma update y'all in that outro. Hey, bruh. Zip up your George. This ain't no bathroom, bruh. We gone. All right, so for this video, we're gonna need Blender, Streamer.bot, and Lens Studio version 4.36.1. Anything after that will not work. All right, we'll start with the simplest methods first. So that'll just be putting 2D images, 2D images onto your model. To get those 2D images, just search for transparent PNGs. Stickpng.com is the website I was using. Let's say the Barack Obama mask, download that, and it's gonna take a minute. So let's let that go. Bring that mask into Lens Studio. There we go. Should be the Obama mask. So what you'll do is you click the plus sign here. We're gonna go to image object and connect that to your head binding. We'll change the texture, whatever you want it to be. Then all you got to do is just resize it and make sure it's in front of your model. We'll go ahead and do that right quick. And you want to use your preview, especially if you have this smooth follow script from my previous videos. If you don't have that, it should fit easily onto the screen here. But with that smooth follow script, you're going to need to use the preview to make sure it lines up right. And then you can go ahead and edit your eyes just for this simple image. When you got it to the place you want it to go, click Project Info, change it, Obama, apply, and you can go ahead and publish that. If you want to get it all done at once, just duplicate this a few times for however many images you got. And then for each one, you'll just change it. Each image you got, let's see, just go down the list. That way you ain't got to restart every time. Alrighty. And then just do the same as the first one. What you'll do is you'll hide whichever one you're not using. So if we want to use object 2, you do the same with the first, just move it, resize it, move your mouth and eyes around to make it fit, change the name in project info. That would be Phantom or whatever. Apply and go ahead and publish that lens. And you're going to do that for every single mask you want to make. Then once you publish your lens, go ahead and fit them all in the lens scheduler in your folder. And then you'll be able to bring up Snap Camera. And you can just favorite them here. And then go ahead and add key bindings to each. And then take note of which ones you put where. And I'll show you how to put that in Streamer.bot a little later. All right, so if you can't find a good PNG transparent file, I got a little workaround where you can use 3D models. So go ahead, open Blender. And we're just gonna delete the box. Make sure you leave the camera and that here light right there. So delete just the box and go to a 3D marketplace, find you a nice mask, go ahead and download whichever one it is. I recommend getting one with holes, preferably for the mouth too, but no big deal. I'd say definitely get you some eye holes in it. Do that, and we'll go ahead and bring that mask into here. And the size don't really matter because all we're doing is taking an image of it. All right. If you got the right size, go ahead and make sure it's clicked and selected. And we'll come to this output box right here. Next to this folder, click it. Put it somewhere so you can find it easily. I'll go to desktop. Make sure file format says PNG and your color is RGBA. Then we'll come up one box to render. Under film, we'll click transparent. Then we're going to want to click this little camera right here. And then drag and rotate to where it's showing perfectly in that camera. So, boom, and you kind of want it dead center. Make sure the textures are loaded. All right, perfect. So from there, you're going to want to go to render, render image. Boom. There's your image. You're going to click image, save as, and then we'll save on desktop. From there, you can come back into Lens Studio. Drag you that image in here. Wait for that to load. Then we'll go ahead, in the meantime, duplicate that. And untitled. And we'll show that. And boom, got you another one. And then go ahead and size that up. Move your mouse and stuff around so it's out the way. Like I said, check your preview image here. Oop, check your preview image here. As you see, my eyes aren't lined up in it, even though it is here. And then go ahead and move it around. You could even rotate it if it makes sense. That's the simple way to do it with your 2D images. Now I'm gonna show you your 3D images. As you can see, my broccoli head's a little too big, so I can't really do 3D images onto my model here. So I'll go ahead and switch to a different one and show you how to do that. Just a note right quick. Also, make sure your mask isn't pushed into your model like this. Bring it out forward. Barely touching. And then adjust your eyes and everything. That way when you turn your head, it'll turn with it. All right, so I got my little avocado here now. You want to find your good 3D images with like a helmet or something. Go ahead and find you one. Download it. I think I downloaded this one maybe right here. Import that. Now you might have to go to Blender, export it as a GLB if you do FBX, because sometimes it don't load the materials. Yeah, it didn't load the material here. Drag that onto the head binding. Bring that up. And all you gotta really do, just drop that sucker on. And then resize it to your liking. Tell you what, get a little texture right quick. Let's see. Materials, car paint. That to the car paint. That black with that. Probably get a little dark right there. Be like an old school helmet at least. But that's pretty much it on how you do 3D helmets and stuff. So for advanced uniforms and outfits, we gotta do that in Blender. Cross your fingers. I'm in no means any kind of expert, barely a novice at Blender, so I can't show you how to change your models besides just attaching them with Control J. That's about it. I know you could take a 2D image, subdivide it a bunch of times, shrink wrap it to your model, and then stretch it out. It's way too time consuming for a video, and I'm not quick enough, to be honest, so I won't be showing y'all how to do that. But once y'all get y'all's lenses ready, add into Streamer.bot. We'll go ahead and open up Streamer.bot. Then you can actually go ahead and open your snap camera just to make sure you got your hotkeys ready if you didn't already mark them down. And then go ahead and open your stream on a different account just so you can test. All right. So once you're in Streamer.bot, you go over to your platforms. If you have a Twitch account, you'll go to accounts here, log into your Twitch. If you have a YouTube, go to accounts, sign in with Google. And once you have that, you come over to your actions, right click, add action, and just name it the name of your lenses. So first I like to start off with my main lens and I just name it original. Click OK. We won't set a trigger for the original, but we will set a sub action, which will be core system keyboard press. And then you just make it whatever your hotkey is. So mine's Control Alt F1 for that. So Control Alt and F1. And I'll show you why we don't put a trigger for that in just a moment. And then you just go down the list and create all those. So I'll do that. Add that to a group. Lens change. There we go. So go ahead and just add all your lenses. So once you have your lens names added on the left here, just click one. We'll go to triggers, right click in that, core, commands, command trigger. And then we're going to create command. And you're just going to name that the same, and then you'll do a little command that people can type into Twitch to change that. And then we'll set your cooldown in seconds. I'm going to do 240 for this here. 240. You can set it to whatever cooldown you want. You'll just want the cooldown to be greater than what we set for your original, which I'll show you in a moment. And create that. And the sub actions will come to core system, keyboard press, and then you'll do like you did with the original and just add that shortcut. And then you'll go down the line and do it all the same with the same delays for all of them. All right, if you think you messed up on one of the commands, it's no big deal. You can click over to this commands tab and you can edit them in here. So I forgot to add cooldowns on a couple. Now, the reason I didn't set this one as a command, because if you type in a command twice, it will turn off the lens and we don't want to do that. So the way that we're going to circumvent that is we'll come to sub actions. We'll add a delay, and you just want to make your delay shorter than the cooldown that you have. So I'll just give you an example. So we'll do a 10,000, and these are in milliseconds, not seconds, so make sure you account for that. We'll go ahead and do a 10,000 millisecond delay on that, and then we'll come here, and we're going to set action, and you're going to click run action, no selected, and we'll just go original, and I'll show you why. So let's bring up snap camera here, open up the chat. All right, so now you see, let me see, I did that on Batman. Okay, so Batman, I see it changes my lens to Batman. Now, because there's a delay, if somebody in your chat tries it, it won't work, but I had my original set too short, so it changed at the same time. But there's that delay on that action, so it wouldn't have changed regardless. So you want to go ahead and add that delay and action to your original lens for every single one. Now, if you try to test it out using just the Streamer.bot chat, it's going to switch regardless of the delay because you're the admin of it. That's why I logged into a different account to test it onto here. So that pretty much wraps it up on how to implement that with Streamer.bot so your chat can type in commands and change your uniforms. See you in outro. I didn't get the job. They said I was too qualified, but I guess that's a good thing. If this video helped you out, leave a like, maybe subscribe. If you got any questions, ask a comment down below. Check me out on Twitch at twitch.tv/brocohleetv. I gotta go call my cousin Francis and maybe my pastor. Tell your mom and them I love them.
Oh, my jaw.